Okay, so today we'll start a new topic, complex numbers. You already studied number system in the previous years, no?
Yeah.
So what are the different numbers? First one is what, natural numbers, right?
Yeah.
And what is bigger than that?
Whole numbers.
The superset.
And rational number. Rational.
Above that?
Irrational.
Integers, right?
Yeah, integers, yeah.
Above that is?
Rational and real.
Okay. And irrational is
included,
independent. Rational numbers and irrational numbers are disjoint sets.
Okay.
And if you combine these two,
real numbers.
That is real numbers. So now we are going to move to the next one, which is
complex.
Yeah. Okay, so there's an equation x square plus y, 1 equal to 0. So what is the value of x which will satisfy this equation?
No real values.
So basically I have to find the value of x such that x square is minus 1. Okay. But square of a number is always positive. So there is no solution for this equation. So you can write x as square root of minus 1. I'm going to introduce a symbol I, which represents square root of minus 1. Okay. So this number, which is square root of minus 1, is called imaginary number. Okay, and a number which is has got two parts where A and B are both real is called a complex number. Okay, right. So the number system can be extended to find the solution of the equation. If we denote square root of minus 1 by I, then the solution of the above equation is I. Okay, so if you put x equal to I in this equation, you will get I square plus 1 equal to 0. And I by definition is square root of minus 1. So I square is minus 1. Okay, so x equal to I will satisfy the solution, but x is a imaginary number. Right. So a number of this form A plus IB, where A and B are real, is called a complex number. Okay, and A is the real part, and denoted by the symbols R, E, Z, and B is the imaginary part of the complex number Z, and the symbol is IMZ. Okay, so now, like real numbers, we can also have different complex numbers. So this is one complex number Z1 and second complex number Z2. And these two numbers are equal if and only if the real components and the imaginary components are equal. Okay, both should be equal, individual. Is this clear? Hello?
Yeah.
Okay, because they cannot be combined, real part and imaginary part cannot be combined. So if two complex numbers are equal, both the real part and the imaginary part should be individually equal. Okay. So like we have algebra of real numbers, we can add them, multiply them, subtract them, divide them, right? So simply can we add two complex numbers, subtract two complex numbers, multiply and divide, so on. Okay. So you can guess these rules. You have two complex numbers Z1 and Z2. Okay, when you add Z1 plus Z2, you will get this one. Is it clear?
Yeah.
Add the real parts and then add the imaginary parts. Okay, the difference between two complex numbers, Z1 minus Z2, is A minus C plus I times C. So Z1 minus Z2 can also be thought of as Z1 plus minus Z2. Okay, and minus Z2 is what? What is minus Z2?
Sir, I don't know.
Z2 is given here, right? C plus ID. So minus Z2 is minus C minus ID. Okay.
Okay.
So multiplying two complex numbers, Z1, Z2. So Z1 is A plus IB and Z2 is C plus ID. Okay. So it's like multiplying two polynomials, you can multiply, right? Say x plus y into x minus y. A similar rule you can apply here. And you know I is square root of minus 1. You have to use that one. By definition, I is square root of minus 1. So what will be I square then? What is
minus
I square? I square is what?
Minus 1, minus 1.
Yeah, so you have to use this thing. Okay, and what will be I cube?
Minus 1 I, minus 1 I.
Minus I. Right?
Yeah.
What is I raised to the power 4?
1.
I square into I square?
Yeah.
So 1. Okay. Similarly, I raised to the power 5. So everything you can reduce. Okay. So that will not use here. So A into C, AC will get, and then I square B into D. Okay. That will also contribute to the real part. The real part will come by multiplying these two also, because I square is real, right? So the real part of Z1 Z2 is this one. Is it clear? And imaginary part will come by multiplying these two and also multiplying these two. That's what is happening here. Okay. So this is how to multiply two complex numbers Z1 Z2. So similar division, dividing two complex numbers Z1 by Z2. So you have to multiply by the conjugate. Z plus ID, the conjugate of it is Z minus ID. Like you can rationalize the irrational numbers, no? 1 divided by root 2 minus 1. You can multiply by root 2 plus 1. Numerator and denominator to rationalize it, right? Similarly, you can multiply the complex number by its conjugate. If A plus IB is a complex number, then its conjugate is A minus IB. Okay, just remember this one. So that's what we're doing. C plus ID, its conjugate is C minus ID. Okay, so denominator will be of the form A plus B into A minus B. That is A square minus B square, and B square is I square D square. Right? And I square is minus 1.
Yeah.
So that is why it is becoming plus. Okay, so if you take a complex number Z and then multiply with its conjugate, the symbol for conjugate is Z bar. Okay, this will be real. Like C plus ID into C minus ID is real number, right?
Yeah.
Okay, this is conjugate. Z bar is conjugate. So once the denominator becomes real, then numerator is multiplying two complex numbers, which we have done previously. So same way you can multiply those two numbers. A plus AC plus BD and then BC minus AD. Clear?
Yeah.
Okay. So again, you have real part which is AC plus BD divided by C square plus D square, and imaginary part is BC minus AD divided by C square plus D square. So this is how to multiply two complex numbers. You have to multiply with the conjugate of the denominator, and the denominator will become real. After that, you just have to use a rule for multiplying two complex numbers. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Power of I, already told you, I square is minus 1. Right? I cube is minus I. I raised to the power 4 is plus 1. I raised to the power 4n, where n is an integer. So that is plus 1. Is it clear? You can write like this. Okay. So even if n is negative, this is true. Is it okay?
Okay.
And I raised to the power n plus 4n plus k, you can split it like this. And I raised to the power 4n is 1, so it's equal to I raised to the power k. Okay?
Yeah.
Okay. Now identities. So z1 plus z2 whole square. The meaning of z1 plus z2 whole square is this one, z1 plus z2 into z1 plus z2. And you know how to multiply two complex numbers. So this will turn out to be z1 square plus 2z1 z2 plus z2 square. Okay. Right. So you're just assuming that z1 into z2 is z1 square, right?
Yeah.
Z1 into z1 is z1 square. Suppose if someone asks you to prove it, that should not be difficult because it's a plus ib into a plus ib. So this will be a square minus b square plus I into AB, it will be twice. Okay. So, right. Yeah, we are not defined. Okay, this is the definition of Z1 square only. This doesn't make sense because Z1 square is not a norm. This is the meaning of Z1 square. Z1 into Z2, that is equal to A square into B square plus I into 2AB. Okay, so Z1 square is a complex number because it's got both real part and the imaginary part. Z1 conjugate is a real number, but Z1 square is a complex number. Okay, so this is how it's being defined. Similarly, Z1 minus Z2 whole square, okay, is this one. Similarly, other algebraic, once you know how to multiply two complex numbers, you can extend these things. Is it clear?
Yeah.
Like A plus B whole cube and A minus B whole cube and A square minus B square. Okay. Right. Now we defined a thing called modulus and conjugate of a complex number. So let us take a complex number Z equal to A plus IB. Okay. We can define something like a modulus, which is square root of A square plus B square. Okay. And conjugate is A minus IB. The imaginary part has to be, the sign has to be reversed. The real part is same. The imaginary part, the sign is reversed. Okay, so this is called conjugate of a complex number. Okay, so what are the meaning of this thing that we'll come to know later? Now, multiplicative inverse of a complex number. What is multiplicative inverse of a real number? Suppose I have a real number, 2.3. What is multiplicative inverse?
Sir, 1 upon 2.3.
Yeah. So multiplicative inverse, if you multiply with the number, it will give me 1. Okay.
So reciprocal.
Yeah, reciprocal. In the case of multiplication. Okay, so multiplication of complex number z is 1 by z. Okay, you can take it as by definition. Okay, and 1 by z is 1 by a plus ib when z is a plus ib. So this you can rationalize. In the sense, like you can multiply the conjugate and then you'll get like this. Just check whether this is correct. Obviously, right? Denominator is a square plus b square. And numerator you have to split into a real part and imaginary part. Is it clear?
Yeah.
And that is equal to this one. Complex conjugate divided by the modulus square. Mod of z is square root of a square plus b square. So a square plus b square is modulus square. Okay. And what is there in the numerator is a conjugate. This is clear?
Yeah.
Okay. So from that you'll get z into z bar. Yes. Take z to the right side and mod z square to the left side. We'll get this one. Is it clear? Take z to the right side and mod z square to the left side. We'll get this equation. So z into z bar is mod z square. It's again consistent with the result that z into z bar is a real number. Because mod z is a real number, if you square it, you get a real number. Okay, so z into z conjugate is a real number. Now let us take two real numbers, z1 and z2. Okay, you can take z1 as a plus ib and z2 as c plus id. Then these things are true. Mod of z1, z2 equal to mod of z1 into z2. You have pen and paper, no? Can you just check it?
Okay.
Take z1 as a plus ib.
Z1 is equal to 2 plus ib and z2.
C plus ib.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Sir, sir, can you explain the first one? How will we get that?
See, z1, z2 is this one, right? A plus ib into c plus id.
Yeah.
That will be equal to this one. AC minus BD.
Okay.
Plus I times. This one is clear?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. And then you have to take the mod, right? The mod is taking real part square and then imaginary part square. This single dash, or single dash here. on the double dash, absent by double dash. Okay, so the important thing is here there will be four terms because see, this is a minus b square and this is a sum minus c plus d square, right? So, but the 2ab and 2cd will cancel because 2ab will have abcd. Okay, similarly 2cd will have again abcd and the negative sign is there, so it will cancel. Got it?
Yeah.
So only thing that will remain is a square c square and then b square d square and then a square d square and b square c square. So four terms will be there. Okay, and square is there on top of it. The left hand side also has got four terms. If you multiply these two, there will again be four terms.
Sir, the sign is from multiplicative inverse.
Which sign? No, conjugate.
Okay.
So the first one is done, no? This also will have four terms.
Yeah.
So the four terms will match.
Okay.
Because a square c square will come here, b square d square will come, and then a square d square will come. And then b square c square will come.
Right. Okay.
Similarly, if you want to prove this one, you have to multiply by conjugate. Z1 by Z2, A plus IB divided by C plus ID, right? So to multiply by C minus ID in the numerator and denominator and then simplify. Okay. So same logic. It will be complicated, but it will simplify. Okay. What about this one? Z1, Z2. Equal to conjugate. This is conjugate.
Okay.
So equal to Z1 conjugate into Z2 conjugate. Just prove one of them. This third one you prove. Because first, once you have to prove one thing, after that it will be clear. You have to show Z1, Z2, conjugate. Do in your paper instead of scribbling. Z1 conjugate to Z2 conjugate. Okay. So this is A plus IB. This is C plus ID. Whole conjugate. You have to relate it to A minus IB into C minus ID. So this is AC minus BD I into AD plus BC. This is the left hand side. And right hand side is same. AC minus minus BD and then I times D Z1 conjugate Z2 conjugate, right? AC plus I square BD. So this is matching. The second term minus I'm taking out. So this, yeah, so this is true. Is it clear?
Yeah.
It's simple only. Similarly, you can prove these things. Just have to take Z1 as A plus IB and Z2 as C plus ID and then simplify. Okay. And Z1 by Z2 conjugate is Z1 conjugate by Z2 conjugate. Okay. So the conjugate is actually just getting distributed in multiplication. The three is multiplication and then addition and then division. In all these three operations, the conjugate operation is getting distributed, right? conjugate of the group is conjugate of the individuals, right? It's just getting distributed. If you just remember that, this is fine. And mod is also getting distributed. Mod of the product is equal to the mod of the individuals. Mod of the quotient is equal to mod of the individuals, right? So both mod and conjugate are getting distributed. Is that clear?
Yeah.
Right. Okay. Solve this problem. I square root of minus 1. And I is the power.
Sir, I7 will be 1 will be I, right? I only.
Okay, you have to use the result. I square is minus 1. And I raised to the power of 4 is how much?
1.
If you use these two, you can simplify this thing. So I raised to the 57, how will you write it?
It will be I only, I think.
Yeah, you have to write the steps properly. You are doing for the first time, no? 56 plus 1. Okay. And 56 is 4 into something, right? 4 into 4, 1s are 4, 14 times into I. Okay, and this is equal to 1. So it is I, the first one. Okay, similarly, I raised to the power 125 is I raised to the power 124 plus 1, right? This is.
Yeah.
4 into something. 4 into
this will also be I1.
This is 4 into 31, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So this is also equal to I. So it is I plus 1 by I. And what is 1 by I? How do you find 1 by I? Whenever there is something in the denominator, you just have to multiply by its conjugate. Rationalize, okay. No? Because things in the denominator are difficult to handle. So just rationalize it. So multiply by minus I and it will become I into minus I. That is minus I square.
By minus I square.
So that is I minus I divided by I square is minus 1, so it is plus 1, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is equal to how much?
So 0.
Okay, so I raised to the power 4 is 1. So from that we can generalize as I raised to the power 4 n is also 1, where n is an integer, not just a natural number. It can be negative also. It can be an integer. It can be minus 1, minus 2 also. Sorry, minus, yes, minus 1, minus 2. Okay. Solve this problem. What is the first step?
So no idea.
See, whenever something is there in the denominator, it's difficult to handle, no? So, multiply by conjugate of the denominator.
Rationalize.
Yeah. Sin theta just puts S.
Yeah.
So, multiply by 1 plus 2is divided by. Is equal to B minus 4 sine square plus I. Yes.
Sir, is the answer A?
Let me check. 1 plus. My denominator is correct. 1 plus 4 is square.
Yeah.
And the numerator?
Yes, sir. Correct.
Okay. So purely imaginary means the real part has to go to 0. So sine square is root 3 by 2. Sorry, sine is root 3 by 2. So it is 60 degrees. And it can be in first quadrant and.
So this was Allen problem?
Yeah.
Okay.
Answer is C. You have to check the quadrant. Because sine, no. Sine is positive in first quadrant and second quadrant. So it should be 60 degrees. And then? So to draw the quadrant. So it's here or here. This is 60 degrees. So it is this n pi plus 60 and this is n pi minus 60. So it's even pi plus 60 and odd pi minus 60. So that's why it's n pi plus or minus pi by 3.
Okay.
So draw this picture. Don't skip this step. Don't skip simple steps so that you will avoid silly mistakes. Okay. Another thing is you are missing any signs. That's okay. We are not missed anything, right? So we just have to put this equal to 0. This thing should be equal to 0. And denominator is not equal to 0. That will not be 0. Right. So this is the only thing. So for that sine square. Okay, sine has to be. Okay, here also I think we are getting more than. See, we are getting sine square as 3 by 4, right? So sine is 3 by root 2. It can be plus or minus, no? What is stopping from minus? Got it?
Yeah.
We have just taken 3 by root 2. It can also be minus 3 by root 2.
Okay.
So that means it can be here also. Okay, this is actually giving 4 solutions, not 2. N pi, even if it's even pi, it's plus or minus. Okay, even odd pi, plus or minus. So this thing is actually giving us 4 angles, right? Got it, no?
Yeah.
All the 4 values are included. So you have to do things properly without missing the steps. Okay. Can you do this one?
Yes, sir.
How will you proceed?
So we can square.
Yeah, and then?
And then we can solve that equation.
Yeah. What is the answer?
Not getting, sir.
Okay, this you have to just Square root is some complex number, right? So let that complex number be a plus ib. Okay, we have to find a and b. Is that clear?
Okay.
So 7 plus 24 I is equal to a square minus b square plus I into 2ab. Is this clear?
Yeah.
So 7 is a square. So if two complex numbers are equal, then the individual real component and the imaginary component should be equal. So 24 okay. equal to 2ab. So now we have two equations and two unknowns. We can solve them. Okay. So this is what 12 equal to a into b. So to use that in this one, from that you will get 7 equal to a square minus b square. So b square is 12 minus a whole square. Okay. So this is a quadratic in. This is quadratic in which variable? Huh? This equation is quadratic in which variable?
One.
Not one. What is the variable? A square, no?
Yeah.
Quadratic in a square means this will have terms a raised to the power 4, a square, and then constant.
Oh, okay, like that.
Okay, then you have to solve for the quadratic equation. Is that correct?
Yeah.
A raised to the power 4 minus 7a square minus 12 square is 0. So 144, if you split, if you get, right. Is it easy to see the roots? 16 into 4, right? Okay. 144, how do you split? 16 and 9. If you split 16 and 9, okay, and when this minus 16, if you add them, we'll get sum of root is plus 7, which will be minus 9, and square root plus 16. If you're not getting this thing, you just have to use the formula square root of b square minus 4ac. 49 plus 4 times 12 square.
We can then 16 and 9.
Okay, okay, so basically you can solve. So these are the values of a square. Okay, from there you have to find the value of a. That's why you're getting values for a as plus and minus 4, not just plus 4, okay? And b is plus and minus 3. Okay, so that's why there are two complex numbers, plus or minus 4 plus 3. Even when you take a square root of a real number, you get plus or minus, right? So simply for the complex number also, you're getting plus or minus. Okay, two things you are getting. Right. But this is a general procedure for finding the square root of a complex number. But what if someone asks you to find reciprocal of this number? How do you find reciprocal of this one, 1 plus? Equal to what? How do you find the reciprocal? How do you find the reciprocal?
7 plus 24.
What? 7?
Sir, I'm solving. Just.
Don't make it complicated. You just have to rationalize it.
Yeah, yeah. I'm doing that.
Fine, you'll get it.
Yeah, sir.
Okay, this is not difficult. It's just lengthy calculation.
Yeah.
Just look at it. This is a complex number because square root of negative quantity will be a complex number. So x square, we just have to square this thing using a plus b whole square formula. Okay. X cube also. And x raised to the power 4. Okay. So if you simplify all these things, you will get this one. finally it is real, it could be complex also. Okay, it's not difficult. Okay.
Yeah.
So this thing we have already seen. Z plus Z conjugate is true or twice real of the complex number. Yes, no? Is this clear? If Z is A plus IB, Z conjugate is A minus IB. So if you add them, you'll get 2A. Correct?
Yeah.
What about Z into Z conjugate? That is A plus IB into A minus IB. Okay, there is a mistake here. It should be A square plus B square. Here, the right hand should be A square plus B square. Got it?
Okay, sir.
There is a mistake here. A square plus B square. Right. Okay. Basically, we have seen what is the modulus of a complex number, square root of A square is B square. Conjugate is A minus IB. And similarly, you can define another quantity called argument. Okay. Argument is tan inverse of B by A. Got it?
Yeah.
Okay. Like we have vectors, no? X component and Y component. Similarly, you can have, here you have two components. So argument you can define as tan inverse of B by A.
Okay.
That's what is defined here. Theta is tan inverse of Y by X, where Z is X plus I Y. Basically, there are two components, real component and imaginary component. Okay. So once you have two components, we can define an angle. Tan inverse of Y by X. Fine.
Okay.
And this imaginary complex number has got two components, no? Real component and imaginary component. So you can represent as a point in the xy plane. The x axis will have the real value and the y axis will have the imaginary value. Okay. So any complex number will be a point in this plane. X, y. It will be x units in the real axis and y units in the imaginary axis. So that will define the point here. And the modulus of the complex number is square root of x square plus y square. So that will be the distance between the origin and the point. So the modulus is basically the distance between the origin and the point. And the argument tan inverse y by x is at this angle with the real axis. Okay. Like a vector will have a magnitude and direction, right? So this is like magnitude of the complex number or the magnitude of the vector, and this is the direction of the vector, which is the argument of the complex number. So is this representation of complex number clear?
Yes, sir.
It can be represented as a point in the xy plane. Okay.
Yeah.
So with your understanding, find modulus, argument, and principle of value of argument, and each positive argument of a complex number. 1 plus I root 3. Okay, this first one, what will be the, okay, this is a point like this, 1 comma root 3 in the xy plane. That is the
mean.
So now we have to find the modulus. That is this distance. So what will be the modulus?
Sir, under root of 1 plus root 3 squared. So
yeah.
It will be 2.
Yeah, it is 2. And what will be the argument?
Sir, tan inverse root 3 by 1.
Yeah, that is how much?
Tan 60 degrees.
Yeah.
Pi by 3.
Yeah. So, okay. So, this is 60 degrees, right? But we can also go one circle and come back to this point. So, what will be that angle? 360 plus 60, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So you can also go 720 plus 60. Come back to the same point.
So n p 60 plus.
So it is 2n pi plus pi by 3.
Okay.
Okay, this is general solution. The first just 60 degrees is called the principal solution, principal value of the argument. Okay, after that, there is a general solution. This is the general solution, and it can also be minus 360 degrees plus 60. Minus 360 from here, I'll come to here, and then plus 60 will go in this direction. Okay, so this can also be n can also be an integer. It can also be minus 720 plus 60. Okay.
Okay.
Minus 4 pi plus pi by 3. Right. Similarly for other complex numbers. It's not difficult. Okay. Similar way. Got it, no? Okay. The sheet will be with you. You can go through it.
Okay.
And try to solve it before looking at the solution, without looking at the solution, and then look at the solution.
Session of physics.
Physics what?
Sir, we'll push to physics now.
11:30.
Okay.
Okay. Find modulus and argument of this one. Right. So this sheet I'll put it in your drive. You just look at it. So all these things are easy, but attempt without looking at the solution. That's important. Okay.
Yeah.
Only then you will get your own method of doing it, which will be more interesting than what is given in the sheet.
Yes, sir.
This number system, the one important thing is this up to when you reach up to rational number, it is like superset. Okay. Like Q is superset of integer. Integer is superset of whole numbers. But once you get to irrational number, rational number and irrational number are disjoint sets.
Yeah.
So disjoint sets. Okay. There is no superset subset relation. But after the real number is combining these two. So real number is superset of all the other ones. And complex number is superset of all everything else. Okay. So have this picture in mind. Okay. Right. This is the so